no place to escape to.
This is the last straight.
On the left.
Right from your glade.
That's when the cannibalism started.
What's up,
everyone? We gotta get ready for the live stream.
Whoa!
Get ready for the live stream. What's gonna put my clothes back on?
Oh my God, your clothes are on, my friend. Welcome. Nope, now you're getting more naked. You're getting more naked. You're living the nightmare that you thought you were having.
Are we live?
We are live. We are live. Look at that. What a man. I got the body of a pig. By the way, I took the vaccine yesterday and I am gonna complain. I think it's making me look more bloated in the face. I think the vaccine is bloating me out. Look at that, Henry.
Yeah,
nailing
you think
it, buddy.
So?
I think so. Henry is out of frame. Currently
you gotta,
not
you gotta
in.
Move
you got to
move it,
Henry. There we go.
There take we that. Are. Yeah, we needed to see that.
That's great. Very
let's
nice.
Get this show started.
Absolutely. Right. Well, thanks, right. Everyone, for tuning in. Hope everyone is safe. I did get the vaccine, the second dose, yesterday, and I do feel overall fine. But again, I am telling you. Look at that, making me puffy.
You think it's making you puffy? Is puffiness a symptom? That
nope.
They've a side effect? No.
Nope.
Kissel,
nope.
I think it might have been the pitchers of beers that
no.
you and I had together in Nashville.
It's the NBA playoffs. That was 2 weeks ago.
It holds. I'm still retaining water up until that. Till this day. I still look. This is all water. This is all. This is not
we
fucking
are.
Meat. This is not fucking carcinogens.
Yeah, we did make a mistake of going to a bar called Jam, just one more, in Manchester, Tennessee, but there was no wine and no liquor, so you had to get drunk off of beer, which is, it's not easy to do.
I also, if
what are you talking about?
The
it's
chat,
very easy to do.
No, because, no, you forget, well, you're not a drinker, Marcus, particularly.
Not really, no.
So if you actually have, let's just say, a cult's amount of tequila at night.
Yes.
Let's just say love has
uh-huh.
won, and maybe
yes.
you need your bottle.
Because you have to get your ideas need to be relaxed in order for them to come out of your mouth.
So mm-hmm. in order to achieve what you could get with a simple glass of tequila, you have to have 10 beers.
Mm. Well, it's also truly, I have said this to myself with shows that my boozing has increased in quarantine, where I'll say, be like, I don't want to get drunk. I'll just have a couple of beers. And then you have a couple of beers and legally
you're drunk.
You're drunk. But you,
are. You
know, but in your spirit, you're still just painfully sober. Yeah. But I do want
to
ask.
And you're just confident to finally drive to the casino.
Yeah. You just do that. Guys, if you're in the chat, I want to know who was one of the wonderful people that was at Jom that warned the bartenders that we were coming. That said, there's going to be two men from out of town that might roll into this place. I want you to tell people to know that, because then when we showed up, people were taking pictures of me and Kissel like we were from we were like in a zoo.
Yeah, like it was Sasquatch and his little brother Sisquatch.
I'm the Sisquatch.
Oh.
All I do is suck and I suck and I suck.
Well, speaking of sucking, it is your mandate this
yeah.
week, Henry.
Yeah, speaking of fucking sucking, I don't know what the hell we're going to get going here. What's going on, Chad? Hey, Chad's going to – is Kissel wearing a tee? Yeah, he's wearing a t-shirt. What do you want from him?
He's wearing a t-shirt.
Ben's goth big titty girlfriend today.
All right, I'll take it.
That's not
just
fair.
Wearing a black t-shirt, that's what you get? That's what you get for just wearing a black t-shirt?
That's
you people. You people.
Well, you wait until all I do is wear my Piggly Wiggly brand. Because I did get a gift in Grundy County. It's a Piggly
yeah.
Wiggly shirt, and I've been looking at it, and I've been saying, I got to put that in the wash so I can wear it again.
We need a honestly, you need a Piggly Wiggly tracksuit.
Mm. I completely agree.
That would be incredible.
Like, yeah. And then I can tell everyone, this is the first store I went to when I was 9 years old, and I got a Snickers bar, and they'd be like, wow, this is a great story.
They gave it to me. That's why I wanted to start doing R drops, where I say stuff like, God, he makes rainbows because that's like your suspenders. And everyone's going to be like, this is incredible. Look at this. What is he? Oh, what is he saying? Is he embedded in the government? Another R drop.
Wow.
Speaking of R drops, I think this one, everyone's saying it's tits out fucking birthday. It's tits out fucking Tuesday. Dana Fox, happy birthday.
Happy
People
birthday.
Saying we look nice.
Thank you.
And guys, let's celebrate today, first of all, by a guy that, man, he left us too soon.
Did he?
Yeah, he left us too soon. I just want to say, Jeffrey, I hope you're safe in heaven right now.
All right.
Welcome to the cum zone. Only cum inside anime girls. Quivering clit. My. Double jointed pussy. Fresh balls. Elegant ejaculation. First the kiss. Then the cum.
Is this
my
actual
dick
testimony?
Is in love,
yeah, I think
with
so.
Pain. Co-op it's cock for the boys, torture. Abby. Stuff my dick into a furnace. Stitch my cock shut.
This is
pressure
gonna
undermine
our entire democracy
balls.
And legal system,
come
but this is funny.
Me.
No.
And make it snappy.
Okay, yep. Well, he definitely had he was thinking about something there. Something about cum.
Yeah.
Do you ever fall for those when they say, like, this game will make you cum in 30 seconds? Do you ever play those games, Marcus?
No, I've never actually played one of the, like, pornographic anime games. I've never actually played it.
The porn makes you cum in 5 seconds.
Yeah, I don't really need a game to make me cum in 30 seconds.
Who is, taking too long to jerk off?
Yeah. I don't know. Honestly, jerking off takes 30 seconds.
It's just I do it for science. I have to do it for scientific reasons, and I'm just so happy when it's all over with.
Papango's good tits are all the way out. Work isn't happy about it, but they know for a fact that they don't come into the office on a Wednesday. That's what I'm talking about, guys. Good work.
Well, speaking of jerking off, though, go on. What were you going to say? I was going to talk about the jail guards, the prison guards for Epstein who are not serving any time because they just took a nap.
Oh, my God. It's not a crime.
Honestly,
it's not a crime to take a nap.
In Barcelona, do they arrest them for going on siesta?
No, they don't.
That's a part of the culture. And so yes, they were there all night. Jeffrey Epstein was all night going, oh, Lord. Like, he was singing his jail songs and shit so they couldn't sleep earlier. It was so difficult for them. They had to take a little bit of a nap.
Epstein.
And then sometimes you just throw, you know, sometimes I sleep and then I just throw some shoelaces voluntarily.
Absolutely. It's like Epstein, yes, the leader of a massive global pedophile ring, perhaps. That is a story. But also the story of the overworked American workforce.
This
also needs to be addressed because these prison guards, they can't sleep at home. They're getting hammered, watching the game, hanging out with their wife. You got to sleep at work.
You know what would have saved all this was robot jail guards.
It's scary. That's scary, but technically you are correct, but that's also horrifying and that's awful and it's a dystopian nightmare and I don't want you to even put it into the world.
It's too late. It's
robot jail guards. It's an interesting idea.
It's going to happen. I think robot jail guards all the way down to robot criminals. And then
you'll have
a whole jail. And then, you know what also could
You just want
them?
Battle bots. This is just battle bots again.
We're trying to get in there. Yeah. We're trying to get in there. You know who really could have saved us all? Goths. Because goths love the night. They actually sleep all day. You know what I mean? And someone could have been there to watch him all night. But instead, there were no goth jail guards. And this is why I think that this program, what we'll do, is it will teach our youths how to become the goth jail guards that we need.
I couldn't agree with you more because the goth, although they may look cryptic, they may look dark, technically very empathetic and very sensitive. But as you just said as well, they're up all night.
They're up all night.
Yeah. And goths spend all their time going around like haunted hospitals, abandoned mental asylums, abandoned prisons. That's all they do all night long, all day long. So
they know their way around.
They do.
Yeah.
And that's why we got to train these kids.
I agree with you on that. Oh, Howcast.
How to be goth. Though people tend to judge them, goths are all about acceptance and a preoccupation with death.
You
will need goth music, hair dye, black clothing, military boots, white foundation and powder, black eyeliner, blood red or black lipstick, and black nail polish.
Okay.
Optional.
I guess so.
Gel, goth accessories like spikes and silver chains, and piercings.
Well,
Step one, buy some goth music. Goth rock bands include Susie and the Banshees, The Cure, and Bauhaus.
And that's it.
Step two, dye your hair.
Yeah, that's true.
Black is traditional, but any unusual color will do. Create spikes with gel if you like. Step three, dress all in black to express your belief in the meaninglessness of life, to make the statement that everything eventually decays and spirals into chaos, and to signify your contempt for pretty colors. Goth girls wear a lot of black corsets and fishnet or mesh tops.
Oh my. If they're good ones.
Step 4. Accessorized to taste with silver chains and jewelry, spiked collars, black leather glovelets, skull belt buckles, studded bootstraps, and so on. Consider getting your lip, tongue, nose, and or an eyebrow pierced.
I think
Step 5.
One of them.
Put on black military boots.
Those are not military
Step 6.
Boots. What military boots?
Cover your
those?
Face in white foundation and powder. Military. Go heavy on the black eyeliner and finish it off with black or blood red lipstick.
Okay,
paint your nails
sure.
black.
Yeah.
To learn what goth looks like, check out album covers
album
or stop
cover.
By a goth nightclub.
You know where those
Step
are.
Step 7. Go
I
to the library.
Wasn't,
most goths are well read in philosophy,
nightclub.
Classic literature, history, religion, history,
Yuck.
And politics. In fact, okay, psychologists have noted that That's goths tend to be more intelligent and creative than the average person.
All right.
Did you know the term goth was coined by
what
the manager of Joy
Division,
who described the band as gothic compared with the
I could see how Ken would say that. Like, that is a manager's idea, thinking that a manager invented the term goth. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
I was the first one to say it. Because these guys that run around all black and stuff, they don't understand. You actually got to say you got a package.
You know what that should have been entitled, by the way? It should have been entitled, How to Be a Poser. Let's be honest.
Yeah,
it is
I think
not
so.
Authentic goth wear. Goth
and
is
Henry
in the
Joy
heart.
Division's manager would have been was British.
Oh yeah, it would be like, oh, yeah, so much. How scary you are. When they hold on, it's called ghosty. They're ghosty rock.
We can't wait to see you if you are in England. We can't wait to be back with you. And Marcus, of course, can't wait for the breakfast.
Oh, can't wait to come to Manchester. Can't wait to get that breakfast, get that English breakfast. Go get all the great wonder. I went to Myers of Keswick this weekend, and I got 2 steak and ale pies. I got some prawn cocktail is what they call them. Some prawn cocktail chips. I got some chocolate.
I eat dick.
You get you're,
you're,
give
I
it
eat
to
actual
you.
Dick meat, and that sounds disgusting. Yeah.
No, prawn cocktails, it's the best chip, the best Walker's chip
no,
there is.
Oh, my God. I have to totally disagree with you, Marcus, because you made the opposite statement a few years ago when we were touring Europe. The prawn was not something you liked, the prawn and mayonnaise sandwich. Let's not forget you made us get rid of it.
Oh, no, the prawn and mayonnaise. And, but that's the thing. That's that prawn was, and mayonnaise sandwich. I'm talking about prawn-flavored, prawn cocktail-flavored chips.
We tried some, and I think that you said they're going prawn crazy around here, and I can't. Be a prawn of this.
Absolutely not. I
won't
love
be a
them.
Prawn of the fucking British food system. Okay.
Absolutely.
But this is not goth. So this is not summer boy goth. Like this doesn't count as goth. Like if you have
that's summer boy
like,
goth.
Yeah, like that's neon. But neon goth is a thing now too.
I mean, what they're describing in that video, they're describing like 1996 goth. I mean, that was goth 25 years ago. Like the goth has evolved since then. Goth is a wide rainbow. It's a wide umbrella.
I missed that whole thing. I really could have. I feel like in the end, if you could position yourself as a fat ginger, like if I knew then that you could have positioned yourself within the goth community at the time, I could have gotten the goth girlfriend I wanted back then. And then you had to make up for it later in life. But at the time, you know, you just didn't understand. You just had to position yourself, become a count.
Nah. Yeah, become absolutely. Dracula, I mean, you did try to do that. It just didn't work out. So, I mean, technically, you tried
I mean,
your
triple XL. They didn't make anything for us.
So why
they didn't make
you...
any like?
Yeah. So you already tried to do the thing that you're talking about, but it just did not work out. But you can be, as we learned from King of the Goths, you can be an overweight goth. Ain't nothing wrong with loving some prawn chips and
no,
also
we all love
loving
this.
Dirt.
You gotta King be your goths. Own big titty goth girlfriend if you want. That's what you gotta do. You gotta make it for yourself. Because sometimes at night, in your hotel, and you just sleep, you just cup it. It's so nice. You go to
is that
sleep
what,
that
do you
way.
Do you sleep cupping your breasts at all?
I touch myself when I sleep. You know what I also have found myself do sometimes when I'm sleeping. And I sleep on my back. What I'll do is stick my hands in the front of my pants, like in my underwear. Like I stick it in the under because I don't like it when my arms hang. So what I'll do is them by stick them like into the top of my underwear, like while I'm sleeping. Whoa.
Okay, Henry is gone.
You know, that's what babies do.
How did you fall off of a chair?
Toddlers do that. Toddlers stick their hands in their pants like that all the time.
That's what Al Bundy did as well. It's what Al Bundy did when he was trying to relax and watch TV. It's just
this thing I can do while I'm sitting, but I don't do this while I'm sitting. I do it while I'm sleeping.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I mean, that's why rarely I fall asleep without the undies on, because I like to do that as well. That's for a little holster. And also, you got to have underwear when you got Jerry. He's always digging around and just like, you have to get out of here.
That's how it is. All right, this is real. Honestly, I hurt myself when I fell.
Yeah, let's, it looks pretty bad.
Let's ask the HL question. Will you shut off the stream?
Okay.
Oh, God.
You know, I've never seen someone fall off of a chair while sitting on it.
I was moving around fast.
Especially so.
There we go. I don't know if this is any good. I have no clue. This is going to be awful.
Praise be to Jesus. The Lord be magnified. Praise be to Jesus. Glory be unto God.
Okay.
Jesus is the only way to heaven. You cannot get to heaven by good works, because we are all sinners. Repent of your sins.
Oh.
And ask Jesus to come into your heart and save you. Once you are saved, you are saved forever. Jesus died on the cross.
This man
to wash away your sins with his blood. Jesus is the only hope so that you can escape hell. If you die in your sins, you will burn in hell.
Oh my.
In the lake of fire forever. Praise be to Jesus. The Lord be magnified. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Power be to the Messiah. Jesus is God come in the flesh. Jesus is the Messiah, the chosen of God. Blessed be the Messiah, Jesus. Honor be to the Messiah, Jesus Christ, who is God come in the flesh.
Okay, I don't know if come in the flesh is really, it's a double meaning, it's a double entendre. Also, how lazy is this televangelist? You can't just offshoot your belief in Christianity and spreading the word. You can't offshoot it to robots. You can't do it with AI. That's a sign of the beast right there. That's an evangelical fail, because you need to put boots on the ground. If you're going to go try to convince people that you're right, you better not get a dang AI robot to tell me, or whatever the hell that thing is. You got to do it yourself.
That's a face app. That's some kind of
That's
app.
A face app?
That's some sort of app, yeah. But would it also be dishonest to give your argument a little bit more gravitas, a little bit more weight, by having an old man deliver it?
If you have to give your argument that you truly believe Jesus is the Son of God and he's about to come down here at any moment, and if you don't follow him, everyone else is going to be eradicated except for you, then like you're missing the point of the story. Because that's just that's a diss on the storyteller, because technically the story itself, if you're not engaged, and that's the fault of the presenter.
Every single religion said flirty fish. Every single one needs titties for Jesus, with women with big old tits, men with hot bodies, with skimpy little outfits on. They trick you into church. That's the only way it really works.
That's just how your mother got your father.
Yes, because that's how you locked out a man. Because up until then, my father was too busy with the ball women.
That's where he met your mother.
Yeah, but what my father didn't know is that he thought he had met a bar woman. And then the bar woman, she transformed into my mother. You know what I mean? Because she didn't know up until then. Because she actually sang a couple of cocktail songs.
Oh.
And I remember, I think my dad at some point was being like, we can spend the whole lives in the bar. And then, you know, she was so excited. You know, my mom was like, oh, yeah, I love it in the bar. I absolutely love it. And then, boom! And then kind of like what they talk about with Robert Stroud, when he talked about when he first felt the jail doors close when he was a teenager, and then you realize you're like, oh, no.
Yeah.
I'm here now. Better start raising birds!
Right. So, yeah, a consensual relationship that leads to marriage, it is a lot like being incarcerated for double murder. Isn't that something? Powerful messages.
Honestly, I feel like everybody deserves, on the wedding, like when you guys are getting married, technically you should have a lawyer on either side fighting as well.
Yeah, that's the whole point. That's what you guys did. You guys all had to do all of that stuff. You had to go to the magistrate. You had to get that thing stamped. You had a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah. I just signed a big book. And all of a sudden, that's it. You're married.
All right.
Yeah, we went to the courthouse where the security guard at the marriage office, the marriage license office, told me and my wife that we looked like brother and sister.
Thank
you. And that's the highest compliment of
all. Thank
Yay.
You. Thank you, sir. Thank that's exactly you. What, yeah, thank you. That's so very cute.
That's kind awesome.
And they let us in anyway.
That's great.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, we are actually. We are brother and sister. We want to make a new kind of baby.
I don't know if it's that new. I think that's where we all came from.
Yeah, technically, it's the classic. That's baby
indeed.
Classic.
Indeed. Mm-hmm. That's royalty, baby.
Let's play this next video. This guy might be one of those classic babies.
Okay.
My name is many things.
Okay.
Everyone calls me Chen Chen.
Yes. Let's play these guys.
I'm going to incorporate my genitalia, which you cannot see. But trust me, the lower half is as naked as the upper half. I beatbox and I'm a musician. I am here to show you what happens when you have too much time on your hands.
Why does he keep doing that with his mouth?
I think he's trying to be Ace Ventura.
I think he's on speed.
You have to have your legs spread evenly apart.
He's moving
length.
Very slow.
Oh. Anyways.
Okay. Oh, he put a little bell on his penis.
No, it's just his dick slapping back and forth. Slap.
Oh, that's just the way that would sound, huh?
Someone's saying this is the other dimensional Marcus.
I'm happy we got you in the one you are now.
Thank you.
He's very technically in shape, but he also looks gaunt and sick.
Yeah.
I think he's on a lot of drugs.
Horrible.
Losing my smack.
It's not really.
Anyways, you get the idea. Like they say, rock out with your cock out.
He's so much fucking more terrifying once he gets close to the camera.
This is why it's like we all love Joaquin Phoenix. He's a great actor.
Yeah.
But you know, you don't have to act like him. Because once you become a dumber version of Joaquin, it just gets worse and worse from there.
Because Joaquin is the only man like that who's also one of the best artists around.
Yeah, so he gets a bit of a pass.
You think that if you just become like that, where you become an unpredictable person, that you think that the art just comes. But actually, Joaquin Phoenix worked really hard to get to this point. Because you also remember, he used to not be that great as an actor.
Yeah.
He just got better and better and better and better and better as he went because he honed it, but he was also probably one of the weirder, nay impossible, people to be around for many years.
Like Shawn Michaels. If you're watching the biography, A&E, Shawn Michaels, professional wrestler, he was very mean to everyone and no one liked him. But when it comes to in-ring talent, he put everyone over and they're like, you're an asshole, but you do this one thing well. So
you do well. You do your job.
That's how you can survive.
You do. You gotta do it right. But this someone didn't survive. This is Titties dropped this, and this comes straight from Titties.
Oh my!
Someone just dropped this.
So this is a Travis infused. This one, okay.
Fucking dead baby. This is the fucking unfucking believable.
That's it. It's only 8 seconds, but it's fully a trend that is happening. This is the new Pogs.
Waiting
is
8 months.
Carrying a dead fetus and.
I just.
Waiting 8 months just for you to come out with no heartbeat.
It's the clown face app. That is the thing that takes it over the edge. It's the fucking. She put it on Snapchat. Was it Snapchat?
The clown face app with the hamster dance song.
I'm not playing it again.
Everyone mourns differently.
We're not playing it again. We're definitely not playing
it again. Not playing it again. It's so disturbing.
We're not. That's not mourning. That's content to her. You know what I mean?
I think she must have been kind of sad because her face was. She put that face app on there. She didn't make herself look like Dom DeLuise, my ghost.
The hamster song.
Because
why the hamster song?
The baby's the size of a hamster, and babies like that song. But obviously, it's not going to bring a baby back to life. Either way,
if it brought a baby back to life, it would win the Nobel Prize.
Did she like tag the dude? Like, did she like? I hope that this wasn't the way where she's like just letting the family know, not everything has to go on TikTok. We're
Twitter. Frank Reynolds, Casey Anthony missed out on a golden opportunity. It comes down to it. It's like if Casey Anthony had made it to TikTok time at that age, I honestly think she'd be like one of those, like, crying about, like, Kaylee while, like, hanging my mom and healing you, like, plays, like, while, like, Kaylee rots in the backseat of her car.
Oh, my goodness. Well, she got into a bar fight in Florida, so Casey's still at it.
She's still at it.
We talked
Did she
about
win?
Well,
no,
the
well, she called the cops. Does that win?
Okay.
Is that
right.
a win?
No, it's not a win.
We talked about this on Side Stories, Marcus. You own a bar. Casey Anthony walks into said bar. You got two options. You got to say, get out of here. Or, wow.
It becomes a Casey Anthony bar.
Wow.
It's a Casey Anthony bar.
Like, you no, just wow. go like, yes.
So you're keeping
yes.
Casey in there. You wouldn't
I'm
be
keeping
like.
Keeping Casey. Yeah.
Wow.
Because
okay.
I want to see what Casey Anthony, like, does. Like, I want to see just
but
Casey
she gets
Anthony
hammered
being
off
Casey
of...
Anthony. Oh, hanging out. God.
People
That's
love
why
yeah,
you own a bar. That's the whole reason why you own a bar is because
I said
Casey Anthony might walk in.
I said it multiple
like
times. I said it multiple times on Side Stories. The bartender is the priest of the secular world. They hear everything and they know everything. So yeah. I agree with you.
I don't know.
I just think However, if I am a bar owner, I would say, do we want to attract a bunch of people who killed their kids?
It's a choice that you make because then OJ comes right around the corner. OJ is definitely going to go.
And it's Florida, so next thing you know, you got a hen party happening, but only because all of these women killed their children.
I will say, however, I would not kick Casey Anthony out if I was the owner. However, if the bartender that was working was uncomfortable with Casey Anthony, like serving Casey Anthony drinks, and they wanted an 86er, you go ahead.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Sure, that makes sense.
Bartender's
that makes
choice.
Sense.
Bartender's really cool. choice. All right. I love it. Very great leadership skill.
She only gets one free drink, though.
Why would she get any free drinks? Why would she get one free drink?
She gets a buyback after two beers.
Yeah, of course.
If it's
no,
happy
in our world,
hour.
It used to be four, but what are you going to do?
If
I guess
it's happy
the
hour.
Inflation. This is for Kissel. This is to cleanse the palate.
All right. Thank God.
Yeah, bartender here, Simple Jack. I would be fascinated.
I am the one, the way your son don't need a gun to get respect up on the street. Under the sun, the best of the sun.
I don't know about this whole Fred phenomenon.
I am the one, the way your son don't need a gun to get respect up on the street. Under the sun, the best of the sun will pop the clock to feed himself and family.
Oh.
This is it. Honestly, if they do it on a loop.
That's fantastic. Everyone's putting bread on their animals now. I don't know if the animals like it, but maybe, I mean, they'll eat it.
What do you mean everybody's putting bread on their animals?
Oh, people are putting cats in burritos, and there's a whole bunch of weird food animal mixing going on, very bizarre stuff.
There was a lot of people saying that the woman with the dead baby had a lot more of those dead baby videos as well. That she actually probably got a lot of content out of that, it seems. Like, she just kind of filled it out.
I didn't.
Just one
how,
time.
How is she even allowed to take the dead baby home?
I feel like if you just take it. You know what I mean? If the baby comes
in the
out of you dead.
Still.
Yeah. Oh, was she?
She was in the hospital. And they give you the baby for a while because then they give it a bunch of costumes you can put on it. You can make it a fireman for 9/11. You can make
it's not
it
an American Girls doll.
Captain
What's
America.
Going on?
Like, you can do all these types of things just because it's options.
Yeah.
Because I think they give you the, like, because then they take the picture, but then it's like $30 for it.
Yeah, who is taking the picture?
Probably the father.
The father or the doctor.
Yeah, or the doctor.
I don't know. That
the
has to be against some kind of Hippocratic oath to have a baby stillborn and then try to get TikTok content out of it. I don't know if doctors
it's better than
do that.
Can you imagine motion born where it's dead but it's still moving around?
Yeah, like half of the squid dinners that you have. It's scary.
It's terrifying.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then you have to go kill it. You know, then you have to fucking really choose to kill it. And they're like, it's already dead, ma'am.
Oh,
it's already
goodness.
Fucking dead. And then they cut it up and then they turn into things to keep celebrities looking young.
Yep, put that on TikTok.
This is all actually, right. We'll put this on the internet. This is on the internet for some reason.
Okay.
I was first born in a laboratory, unknowingly falling into a pit of immortality. Life is hell. Hidden from this world where nobody can find me. Frank, throw me in the river so that I can be at peace. Throw me in the river and let me sink to the
No, I want to
sex seems fine. Live audio of Death Bunny.
I don't know what this is.
I knew everything in the universe, yet I could not fall in love. I was forever trapped in an infinite timeline of pain and suffering. I envy death.
You know, it's interesting. Okay. You know, the guy who made that video? Hmm. Remember the guy wearing all leather in the bathtub?
Yeah.
The video that should, same dude.
Now, isn't that interesting? If you told me that the video was about him when he was a magistrate, I would have thought that was shocking. It seems to correlate.
Yeah. No. He's definitely got his own. Or is it, I think Wet Leather is the name of the channel.
Same guy.
Yeah, it's the same guy. Same artiste.
Whoa. Wow. Honestly, I love an artist. And I love what artists do. I'll never question a performance artist because some of them actually get degrees in that horseshit. I don't even know how they do it, but they manage to get degrees doing it.
What do you mean you don't know how they do it? They're conned into going to theater school.
Yeah.
And then you have to pay so much money to them forever.
I guess you really have to, right?
Yeah, I mean, like, you don't have to. You can die with student debt and just like. I don't. Do you have to pay it?
It's Leather Bath is the name of the guy.
Oh. Leather Bath.
Leather Bath. I'm looking at these videos now because it's the top one. That video is called Rubber Nun is Depressed. Oh yeah, and it's got the Law and Order SVU episode as well. It's the same shit.
Yeah, the Chihuahua.
It's got the Chihuahua guy too. I forgot about that.
That's
as
great.
Well. I miss old YouTube artists.
Yeah, this guy's definitely of the old school. The old school YouTube artist bent, where they just did weird shit for no reason, for nobody. Except for themselves.
Yeah, because that's what it comes down to. And I really feel like that's a point that is missed. It can't all just be for content for sale.
No.
Some things you have to do for yourself.
Everything you got to do for yourself. Content for other people is fleeting, and it does not last the test of time. It's here and it's gone.
People don't even know what they want. You know what I mean? They don't know what they want. They think they know what they want. They want 19 Star Wars. When it comes down to, you don't really want 19 Star Wars. You want the feeling that you had as a boy or whatever you were when you were watching Star Wars for the
girl.
First time. You want that, whatever that you are. You want that feeling back. But guess what? It doesn't fucking come back. Because you know what brings it back? Cocaine.
Well, I mean, I don't know if that's necessarily true. A little nostalgia. People seem to love The Mandalorian. It seems like it's hitting them little
Mandalorian.
I didn't
like
watch it. I don't know.
It was good.
I haven't ever seen it.
Sasha Banks is going to be, I think she's nominated for a supporting actress Oscar or something like that. Maybe something with TV shows. What is that called? Golden Globes, maybe.
Emmys.
Maybe an Emmy.
What? They fucking already happened. I don't know what this
fun.
Is.
It was fun. It was
it's
a
fine.
Way to, it was a way to pass the time.
Let's all look at this. What is this? What is the stream? I don't even remember what this is.
May I please smoke here? What am I to do? I cannot smoke, not in the house. I cannot smoke, so says my spouse. No matter how I fuss and growls, what am I to do?
It does. Like he's about to shoot his brain through.
What am I to do? The boss says no for all.
You know, he doesn't
time.
Seem to have a lot of joy, though.
The dog says bad for health.
He's desperate
so
to smoke.
Fine. Yet I have smoked since I was 9.
Oh.
What am I to do?
Well, you're going to have to quit.
May
he's got a tremor or
here.
He's playing the guitar.
He's playing.
I
think it's the sit-down steel.
May I please smoke here? What am I to do? I cannot smoke, not in the car. I cannot smoke, not near or far. No one wants my wee cigar. What am I to do? May I please smoke here?
It's hard. Where are you? Last of those places you can legally smoke.
May I please smoke here? What am I to do? One says it stinks, so yes it
My favorite John Prine song.
Wow. Well, good work. If you're in prison, that's a fantastic song for your bunkie to sing over and over and over.
Do you remember that, man? Because that was really the final, I think, nail in the coffin for me for smoking was the constant ostracization that made me then want to smoke more. The more people were like, you can't smoke here, the more I was just like, oh, well, now I'm definitely.
This is why you're susceptible to cult-like mentality.
Oh, no, man, not necessarily. It's the opposite, yes. You long-haired droogie. No, I actually wanted to smoke because I like the actual sensation. You understand, Marcus.
Oh, no, well, for me,
you need a persecution complex.
Well, for me, what I loved about smoking, like, I actually liked that you could smoke in less and less places, because what that meant is that when I needed a cigarette, which was very often, that meant that I could go away from everybody else and leave people and leave humanity, because, you know, hanging out with people constantly is quite exhausting. I could leave, I could take a little break, and I could
miss
go
that.
And I could smoke and I could just fucking be alone.
The
be
societal
alone, goddammit,
ability
for just a little
to just...
bit.
Being able to, like, walk out of a situation to go smoke was always really fun. That was pretty sweet.
I'm going to go have a cigarette.
And then you get to go do whatever bullshit as you leave. But the problem is that eventually makes you throw up blood, which is why I had to stop.
Yeah, same here. Yeah, it was starting to get scary.
Why did I have to go into the throw up blood part?
Why does smoking have to turn into throwing up blood? Cancer.
I think it messes with your lungs from what I've heard. Although only 1 in 10 die. Isn't that something?
My father's fine. He still smokes 3 packs a day.
I mean, your father is not fine. That's why your mother refused to tell you how he's doing physically, because she said when you see him, you're not going to recognize him. But he does smoke 3 packs a day.
He does smoke 3, but he's fine. I mean, in terms of, like, his lungs are not what is going to kill him.
I know. My uncle was the same way. He was in Germany, died at 86 of brain cancer. Lungs clean as a whistle.
It's weird. The lungs are fine.
It's very weird. But it can't be good for you. It's still, I'm sure that it's still not, maybe it is keeping your dad alive. I don't know.
I don't think so. I don't know.
I don't think he's
don't
allowed
think
to quit.
Keeping
though.
Him alive.
He can't
I think
quit,
if he
though.
Had like an actual, he can't quit. Oh, if no, he quit, no. It'll die. The doctor straight up said if he quits, he'll die. That's how it is.
Which is so bizarre. I mean, I guess he won. He finally got to go to the doctor, and the doctor said, keep smoking. So your dad accomplished some bizarre goal that he wanted to have.
Yes, G-Store, my dad smoked for 35 years and he's dead now. That's how it goes.
Look at that.
That's, hey, you know, it's just that simple. It's just how it goes.
Roll
it's
the dice. It.
Roll of the dice. All
Let's
right.
see what we got here. Let's see what this video is.
Howdy, assholes. My name is Jack Jambi, and I'm a patented liquor queen. Here down in Shittsville, me and my wife, Doug Brown. A store for the locals. For the most part, it's a quiet town. But every once in a while, you get one of these uppity crazy fucks that just go.
Uh-oh.
Hey, I'm gonna drive into your dining room.
Oh my god. Okay, well, you're going to want to be careful. I actually agree with the local town folks there. If people do come into your town, be a little bit more respectful than that. Don't drive your car through somebody's house.
Absolutely.
That's got to be crazy. I've never been that drunk behind the wheel. You're in a house.
I knew someone in high school who drove their car through the house, and it was like directly across from the high school. So I was driving in, and I was like, wow, he definitely did that. But that was kind of a fun story. He did get expelled, but he's doing just fine.
A lot of that comes from when you accidentally step on the accelerator instead of the brake.
Yeah, I think he just took a turn too far, and then, you know, he took it too hard, like he was Fast and the Furious, and then he just went through somebody's house. But thankfully, he didn't kill anyone, because what a bad way to die. What do you think? Donnie Darko style. You got something falling from the
inside of your own house? Oh, yeah.
Inside, in your living room. So you got an engine falling from a plane or somebody driving through your... I would just be like, what are you doing? Why are you driving through my house?
It scares me. I think about it. I sometimes can't look up at the sky because I'm afraid something's going to fall out of the sky and hit me on the head.
That's why you have to be ready for it.
I think about it all the time. I'm very afraid of that random death. Because the random death is almost scarier than, like, the encroaching... tide of age.
And with all the asteroids and stuff out there, but all of a sudden you put a couple mirrors on your feet, next thing you know, you're a pervert. But I'm just trying to look at the sky, even if I'm looking down.
I'm looking at the sky. My dad used to talk about that from back in the day as kids, that that was what was fun to do. They used to walk around with the mirrors tied to their shoes so they could see girls' panties. But back in the day, the panties weren't that exciting. Now panties are exciting.
Perhaps there's a correlation between the more exciting panty and the limited view. I don't know. Your father is a good man, just out there in Queens with mirrors on his shoes.
Back in the day, his favorite movie's Porky's.
If your not favorite, ironically,
His favorite movie to this day. He's just been like, I love it when they look through the shower. Now he's just been like, well, it's different now, Dad. Now
well, it's
technically
a movie.
All of its crimes.
Yeah. It is. Well, I think it was then too. But then she does the dick. Mrs.
Yeah.
Ratchet
grabs
through
the
hole.
Yeah.
Coach Ratchet, I think, something like that. Yeah, grabs his dick through the hole. Lucky guy.
That's what they just don't make them like that anymore.
No, they don't.
For a reason.
Both in film and gym teacher.
No.
All right.
Look at this shit.
Let's take a look here.
What is this?
This is fun. I like anything that has to do with mayo.
Oh my god, this guy's a mayo pig. Oh gosh.
Give me that sound.
I never see a mayo pig. Oh wow.
There we go. It is.
Yeah, probably. What kind of video is this?
Art. This is more art.
I don't. There's a fine line.
Henry.
Look at it.
Well, at least put it on a sandwich or something, and you're just going to stop it.
I mean, honestly.
Why did he touch the computer with the dirty hand?
Yeah, he had a whole clean hand there.
He had a whole clean hand. I don't respect this man because he didn't put his face in it. And if you're going to go and be a star, I need to know who you are.
You have to honestly present yourself in a way that the whole world wants to know.
Who are you?
What's your deal? I want you to talk.
You can't just be
a part of the whole scenario.
You can't just be mayonnaise. You can't be mayonnaise hand. I want to know the mayonnaise man. I want to know the man behind the hand.
When I first watched it, I was really kind of upset that they didn't fucking eat it.
Well, I could have gone for a little white bread, slather it on there, a little bologna, a little piece of square cheese. Boom, pop that right back on there.
What I used to love about the white bread with mayo is that create that sort of like, I don't know how to put it. It's not some kind of paste. It would become like a solid and it would fill the entire roof of my mouth with just like white bread kind of mayonnaise, like a plasma. And you scrape it off with your finger.
That sounds like you would have loved the prawn and mayonnaise sandwich we got in Edinburgh.
I tried it.
But
it was
you
awful.
Still didn't eat it.
It was one of the worst things I ever put in my mouth. And also with the mayonnaise guy, well, why was the pig nose on? I saw no piggish behavior there.
Really none, except for the waste of a jar of mayonnaise.
But pigs don't waste food.
And the mess
that
was, it was a messy situation.
Pigs roll around in some of it.
Yeah, a little bit.
Pigs will roll around in anything.
And will eat anything, too.
Yeah, that's why they're so fun. I'm still looking to get my big old pot-belly pig. I'm going to get one day.
Would you be able to bring that into your rented home?
Of course.
Like, even if it's a straight-up pig?
It's a therapy pig. It goes to therapy.
The pig goes to therapy. That's actually a really good
idea. Can you imagine what pigs have to go through? It would have survival guilt. Because of all the pigs that we kill and slaughter all the time. So he'd be like, why am I here?
Ask Puffin, Puffin's the one who served fucking hard time.
Yeah.
Puffin decided to steal a piece of chicken off of a grill. He's very good at getting the food. And then Jerry ran away this morning, Marcus. He ran into a house that was under construction. So we had all these people. They were like, oh, my God. I was like, I'm so sorry. I got to get my dog. He went up the flight of stairs. I was covered in dust when I showed up today.
It was like a cartoon. He showed up like he's like all covered in fucking plaster. And I was like, what happened?
It was horrible.
You did like
so
a
did
level
he just run
of
out of the
game.
Front door?
Yeah.
That's just it. Yeah. There's got to be some sort of like force field that
a
you
BB
can set
gun.
Up.
I'm going to start getting plastic. Remember those plastic BBs? I got to start peppering that little guy.
You might want to get him one of those little electronic collars.
No, because they actually, I looked into it. He's too tiny.
Oh.
Isn't that weird?
But
no, I was thinking maybe a little squirt gun.
If you have a doctor, cut off one of his feet.
Yeah.
I mean, really, all you're going to do is you got to cut off the two, the ones that are kittywampus from each other. And then you got a two-legged dog, but there will be no way for it to really move. Then I have to carry it everywhere. And then I like that it has mobility. You know, because it's nice for me.
We had to do a bunch of when Wendy was shitting blood for 3 days. They had to go and they ran through, you know, obviously gave her the first time she ever had a full body x-ray. And I guess little dogs have a thing called floating kneecaps that you can get where her kneecaps float off her bones or some shit. I was like, what? They're like, yeah, that's what it does. I was like, attach them. Like, go in there and make them not floated.
What do you want to glue them?
Anchor on them. I don't know. I think you could do something to them, and they're like, nah, unfortunately, they're going to always float. And then one day her legs are just going to stop working. I was like, what do you mean her legs just stop working like it's a fucking iPod? You know what I mean? Like this built-in obsolescence?
I'm so happy I took my dog to this depression vet, and I paid good money to get told my dog is going to die.
It's called a luxating patella.
That's what it's called. I didn't know what the hell that means. Some fucking bullshit.
It means floating kneecaps.
Man, those you show up with the dog at the doggy urgent care. You go. You hand him the dog when he's just like all fucked up. They go to take it in the room. The first thing they do, like, okay, you want us to do all the shit to this dog? 10% up top. And then they give you a list of all the things. And you're like, and you're buried. You're just like, I just take my fucking credit card. I don't give a fuck. Like, it is. It's ridiculous.
It's a shakedown.
You immediately charge like a fucking $500. I mean, like, now we'll see if it dies or not.
It's a shakedown. But you did learn so much. You learned your dog has floating kneecaps. You learned it's going to die.
Luxating patella.
I don't even know what it means. Patella. Look, and watch it. Maybe something like this. What happens? You got to be careful out there with these animals.
Be careful now that we're all getting out there. I am feeling quite odd now with the vax, to be honest.
So this is a guy getting food in the seafood chat.
Where is he? Can't see it.
He is a very big British man, as you're going to see.
Ooh, that's the clairvoyant. Yeah, that's about my height right there.
Yeah, he's a big guy. Gets whatever it is he's getting into seafood shack.
It might be a low on.
He's a big guy. Because you'll see, as he comes out, I guess they were having problems.
What's the problem?
Watch, you'll see. Coming out. Here comes his
bird. Oh my god. Wait, oh, I saw that.
The fucking head. Like, he's got a very fast hand.
He's a former fighter. You can tell. That guy's
jab.
Look, if you actually bring it back, bring it back so we could see. Look at how fast he jabs this bird.
And we've all been to Coney Island, so the birds are very aggressive. He's got a piece of shrimp in there. He can see the shrimp.
Oh, yeah, he's coming right back.
What? And the bird survives. It's a good wallop.
I wonder if you don't cut your hand on the beak like that.
He's not even proud of himself.
No, he just kind of knew he had to do it.
He had to defend his free sample that he got from the seafood spot. Just go buy one of the things. Anyway.
If I punched a bird to protect my meal, I'd be so fucking happy. Do you see what I just fucking did?
Just
punched a fucking bird.
Also,
it's like he does it 3 times a day.
I would truly be very scared of punching a bird in New York, though.
Why?
Because they feel like they get punched. You know what I mean? And pigeons? They're used to getting punched. And they're also
I don't mess with them.
They're covered with actual, like, the AIDS on them. You can see. Like, you can see the disease. It has become little creatures that is on top of them. I'd be afraid.
Well, I'm sure we'll talk about this more at some point, but the bubonic plague, isn't that what they say? The rats and the birds.
It's not just what they say.
It's the fleas.
It's the fleas on the rats and the birds. But you know what? I actually like pigeons. I don't care.
I love pigeons.
I love
pigeons. I was dumped on one time, but I think they're kind of fun. And in Williamsburg, they get so fat. I remember one pigeon had to be 6 pounds. It was as big as the Chihuahua I was taking care of at the time. Mm-hmm. But it could still fly away, kind of.
Honestly, they're cute. You know, they're
very
cute.
First time I visited New York, a pigeon shat on my head in the first 30 minutes.
Wow.
It was
technically, that's supposed to be money's going to come to you.
Hey.
There you go.
Look what it did.
The city's
15
been
years
good
later.
To me. Yeah, New York City's been very good to me.
Look at him. Look at him. You should run for mayor.
Ooh, I should. I do better than anybody running right now.
Yeah, get him here. Drag him. Drag him, King.
I've been following that situation from afar, and it seems like some campaign managers are doing a horrible job.
Doing a real bad job.
You have to come on Top Hat. We will do. Marcus is going to come on Top Hat and give us the New York City mayoral, the scoop, the lowdown.
Right before, I've got some opinions. I've got some ideas. I definitely have some opinions on what's been going on this election cycle, because there's been some dirty shit happening, and if certain people get in, there's going to be even more dirty
suggestion,
shit.
Suggestion, replace water with soda. Let's play this video and see what this shit's all about.
I think our bones would deteriorate if we slammed it, if we slam in soda.
I don't think... We're missing the video, I think. We're missing the video. Yeah. Because actually, the sounds are just.
Is this sounds from Henry's wedding night?
Hey, come on now. Hey.
Going. Out of the truffle hog eat.
Yes, finally.
Okay. Well, that was a great video.
We have to see that video. Here we go. Yeah, let's check it out. Let's take a look at this. Everyone loves this.
Okay.
Everyone's
going to
love this. Oh, I see. Dating is hard.
That's sweet and sour.
This is what I used to do for hours as a child.
Whoa. Oh my God! Oh! What is wrong? What is wrong with you?
Jeez. I used to do this.
But
I
used to do that. You used to do cunnilingus on gummy figures. I think this man needs to be investigated. Oh my God!
Guys, did you do all of this shit?
This dude is taking it to a new level, man.
What?
Next level shit.
Oh, look at that.
It took me a second to figure out what the hell I was looking at. Well, good for him. I mean, it's just nice that the puppet arts are still here with us.
Thriving.
I can't wait. I would love to go to more puppet shows, tangible presentations.
Don't ever fucking say that out loud ever again. Say you want to go to more puppet shows.
I want to go to a puppet show. I'll go to a puppet show right now. What do you have against puppet shows?
Next time I come to LA, we'll find a puppet show and I'll go to a puppet show with you.
Guys, you're going to get molested.
No. I mean, we won't be let in if it's a children's puppet show, but I'm sure they do adult-themed puppet shows.
Yeah.
That is where they molest you as an adult.
I'm going to be 40 by then. And holding.
Hey, man, when you're 40, that's when things are really going to change.
Yeah.
40 is the fucking, you're taking the lid off. You're fucking, this is it. This is your time. It's your time to thrive. It's your time to not just fucking, you're going to be bigger, badder, better. Yes, King.
Well, I don't think that works because it's 39 is 30 thrive.
30 thrive, 40.
Wait, maybe that's 35.
Feeling Gordy.
Yeah, there we go. Gordy. Triple hug.
Honestly, you
I'm
might...
the body of a pig.
You remember him? I miss him, man.
We can just YouTube I have the body of a pig and find it again.
Yeah.
He's just out there. But I wonder if he made any other content.
I don't know.
It was a ghost.
All of those guys that I have the body of the pig, that was all before OnlyFans, too, before they could really make money off of like making themselves all swollen.
I would be interested to see the monetization of the swollen male belly.
I say here, Silk Won't says you start to really know who you really are at 40. Take it from a 46-year-old.
Wow. So she's technically only 6, which means she has to stop watching the show.
Yeah.
And get out of our chat. You're a baby.
Yeah, horny 40s. I honestly think you might be the horniest you've ever been during your 40s.
Maybe.
Could be.
I feel like I get fornier. I get fornier. That's what it is. Fornier. I'm getting hornier as I get older.
Isn't that nice for your wife?
Yeah, I'm going up and down, you know, ebbs and flows. I'm at a high point right now. Feeling good.
Wow.
Feeling frisky.
Fuck yeah, bro. Yeah, white boy 40-year-old summer. That's what you're going to do this summer.
Oh, maybe I'll see Chet around Hollywood. I'm so happy I moved here so I could see stars like Chet Hanks.
Oh, and it's like, I hang out all day, man. And you're like, I don't know, Chet.
Did you never have to work a day in your life? Wow, Chet, cool.
Damn, man. I don't have to try. Boom, McClot.
How did you manage to ruin something that was so easy not to ruin? Which was the Hank's
Jamaican,
name.
Man. Yeah, exactly. No, because somebody had to. Because Q tried it, but it wouldn't stick.
No.
Right? Because no one really believed, even though I do, of all the things I do believe, that Tom Hanks.
Don't even say it. I'm not allowing you to say it because the jokes have gotten too serious. You can say Bill Gates, though, because that has now been identified.
I think Tom Hanks might at least, like,
no?
Gave him a chunk of baby. He just go.
No, they don't eat babies, goddammit.
I know. We don't know what they do. Well, I've never been to Hollywood.
Point, counterpoint.
There we go. Big.
The new
true.
Satanic panic is coming, and we're going to get swept up in it if we're not fucking careful.
Tom is fine.
I guess, is fine. I haven't been to his
he
house.
He is, because I love he and his wife and the whole family. Fantastic.
Rita's not adding anything. Let's just
fantastic.
Play this video.
You are just incorrigible. Marcus, he is incorrigible.
Just this, man.
Dude, I'll watch this all day.
Sometimes
this is all of my. This is literally my Instagram.
Yes.
Oh, I love a good fresh ravioli.
I love ravioli.
I made ravioli on Sunday night. It was wonderful.
What, by hand?
No. No, no, but it was nice ravioli, and we used sauce that we made ourselves.
What's the spot in Brooklyn that's OG? They filmed actually like movies there and stuff like that.
The one over in Williamsburg?
The one in Williamsburg, yeah. Not Roberto's. It's so good. We're
it's
gonna
amazing.
Go there.
Yeah.
What's its name? Not Lob. Barubia. It's
Barubia.
Like it's the red sauce joint.
Lilia.
What is
no,
it?
Lilia. No, Lilia's the fancy
Lilia,
one.
Right?
Lily is the fancy one. I'm talking about the one that was the OG mob hangout. That's just great. They still, like, all the waiters wear, like, you know, suits and stuff.
It is
oh, the one over,
the
yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Barbarella's, something like that. It's got an Italian name.
La Maconda?
No.
La Maconda, no. It's across the street from
Da Lilia. Francesca.
Not Da Francesca.
It could be. No, that's my steakhouse.
Oh, Montes.
Yes.
No.
Montessori.
Sacro?
Best Italian food.
This Lily's is great content.
Brooklyn. No, I don't care. Now I'm starving. I'm honestly starving. But Lilia, ooh, that's a nice. You know what it is? It's not. It's Bamontes.
Bamontes. That's it. Go to Bamontes.
Amazing.
That's where that you want to awesome. Go, friend. That's where you go. And if you go one time, like, they know you forever. They do the thing. Mm-hmm. They pull out the chair for you. They're like, Mrs. Zabrowski. Oh, and then you go like, yeah, fucking Tony, you're hilarious. And then you go like, hey, what do you gotta do? I woke up a horny this morning.
Wow, you must be over 40. I would say if you're touring and you only have one place to go between Bamontes or Peter Luger's, go to Bamontes.
Go to Bamontes.
Peter Luger's is a little overrated.
That is incorrect.
I think it's slightly overrated.
That is,
it's maybe a little. It's a little too expensive.
That's
too expensive. Wonderful.
That's the definition of overrated.
No, it's not, because overrated is everyone saying it's the best, is the best, and the best, and then it not being really good. The steak at Luger's is impeccable.
Yeah,
it is still the best, but it is far too expensive for them.
Then
to
it's over. Rude. Then yeah. I believe that by definition proves it's overrated.
They charge $15 for tomato slices.
That is too much. But you go to what's its putts, the even better place that is on Metropolitan.
The place that I go to, De Stefano's.
Not De Stefano's, which is also, but it is good. Oh, yeah.
This is great. How much time is left in this stream?
I don't care,
we have two
man.
More
I'm
minutes,
gonna,
buddy.
I'm just going to just talk about this for the rest. St. Anselm. St. Anselm is.
If you can get a freaking table with the hipsters, they wait there. They wait outside. They wait in lines like it's a night at the Roxy.
You go and you take your time. And you know that it's going to take a little while, because they also don't. You put your name in. You go to the bar next door, right? Because now it's a comedy club, so you can't do that anymore. But then you can go around the other corner. You can go down Bedford. You go to, well, Rosemary's is gone too. You can't go there anymore. But you can go to
the only one that's left is Skinny Dennis and Lucky Dog, where you can actually bring your dogs.
Yeah, and I do like Lucky Dog.
I love Lucky Dog. Well,
the other spot,
either
Rock'n'Roll,
way,
you can't go anymore either, because that became a weird fucking MAGA place. And then you can
go to Rock'n'Roll. I know the people who run Rock'n'Roll. They're very sweet. Bars.
I love Rock'n'Roll.
Maybe there was a couple of D-bags there.
Yeah, there's D-bags in every fucking place.
We did have to kick some of them, because you know my favorite bar is at Skinny Dennis, which is a old country bar. So sometimes we'd be like, I think we can do whatever and say whatever we want here. It's like, you don't know old country then.
No,
Outlaw
you don't.
Is the most
Logan
open-minded country there is. Get out of here.
Logan Arelli in the chat says, wish me luck at the dick appointment, y'all. Congrats. I hope
honestly,
it's okay.
Good luck. I hope it gets bigger or smaller or whatever you want to do with it. All right.
We can close the show.
Do we want to announce that we might be changing?
Guys. Okay, so this
weeks,
is
we have a small
this
change.
Is some housekeeping. We're gonna have some. We're looking at changing the last podcast schedule, not the release dates of anything, but it's because we're about to start going back on the road. And the last time we went on the road throughout 2019, we became what might be called suicidally burnt out.
Bud Dwyer's.
And we don't want to get there anymore. What we want to do is figure out a way to make all of the schedule work for us. So what that means for us is that we're going to need to switch. Normally, this is very candorous. Normally, we record last podcast on Friday, and you get it fresh, right? It comes to order. But what we're going to be doing is...
Well, it's still going to come to order. It's not a hamburger.
It still will be fresh.
Moving the stream to Mondays.
Yeah. But we have to record on Wednesdays, last podcast, so this stream has to move to a Monday evening, same time on Monday.
Yes. That was the most long-winded way to say
I
that.
Like people knowing but that we're all processes.
Yes, I understand. Yes, indeed. So... anyway, all
they
right,
know
everyone.
We work hard on the show and we want the show to be a good right because when you come to Bamante sometimes it's okay if I touch your girlfriend a little bit and
that is
like,
not
hey,
good Bamante
doing this Bamante
all right yes, everyone hail yourself
not next week the week after we will be doing this show the live version on Monday
so. 2 weeks
2 weeks